Hey, how are you doing? Welcome to Mr. Hack. I also welcome you all to a new series on Spring Integration. Spring Integration is an open source framework that enables lightweight messaging within Spring-based applications and also supports integration with external systems. Confused and wondering, like why and how? Don't worry, I will cover it step by step to help you understand it with ease. The series will cover Spring Integration, its components, along with project creation and execution. So, if you are new to Spring Integration, this series will be very useful to you. Or if you know anyone willing to learn the same, do share and suggest this Spring Integration series to them. Today in this video, we will understand what is Spring Integration. But before we go ahead, make sure to subscribe to Ms. Tech Hack so you don't miss on any of our updates and latest videos. So let's get started. Now, what is Spring Integration? Spring Integration is an open source framework for enterprise application integration. Let's understand how it works. Say we have a producer or sender and a consumer or receiver. Now we have a pipe which act as a channel between the two. Producer and consumer are also called as message endpoints, and the message goes from producer to consumer through the channel. Now, we will see some of the basic components of Spring Integration framework. Let's start with transformer and filter. A transformer converts the contents of a message, that is, transforms the message from one form to another. A filter determines if a message can continue its way to the output channel, that is, filter out the messages going forward. Both have a simple flow. There is an input channel that pass the input message to the component. Component generates the output message by transforming or filtering and send it to the output channel. Next is router. A router decides to which channel the message will be sent. The message goes from the input channel to the router component. The component further decides and redirects the message to output channel A or output channel B based on its criteria. Next, splitter and aggregator. A splitter splits the message in several parts, and an aggregator combines several messages into a single one. Both works hand in hand. The message goes from the input channel to splitter component. This component splits the message into several parts. These individual parts are processed. Then all the message parts go to the aggregator component. This component combines all of them into a single message, and this message is then sent to the output channel. Next, service activator. A service activator can invoke an operation on a service object. The message goes from input channel to service activator. The component calls the processing method of the service bean, that is POJO. If message is passed, it will perform some operation on the message. If no message passed, it acts as event style component, which gets triggered on arrival of a message. If the service method returns a message, then it is further sent to the output channel. Next, channel adapter. A channel adapter connects the application to an external system, unidirectional, which means the flow can be either inbound or outbound. Inbound flow uses output channel, while outbound flow uses input channel. Inbound channel adapters are used for one-way integration to bring data into the messaging application. So, in inbound flow, the source of the message is an external system which goes to the output channel through the channel adapter. Outbound channel adapters are used for one-way integration to send data out of the messaging application. So, in outbound flow, the message goes from input channel to the target, that is the external system, through the channel adapter. So, we have seen what is Spring integration, its components, and how it works. That's it for this video. I hope you find it useful. For any queries or concerns, write me down in the comment section. Thank you so much. Have a great day.